sides, so to speak.
And I would tell you what's very interesting about TMS is...
What is the next evolution of transportation management technology? We'll find out in my conversation today with David Landau. He is Executive Vice President of Cloud Logistics. David, welcome.
Thank you, Bob.
So what is driving growth and activity in the transportation management system, or TMS, space today?
You know, Bob, it's a very exciting time in TMS. I think you're seeing a couple of different things happen. On one hand, you're seeing a lot of pressures for shippers they've never had before. For the last 4 or 5 years, or even longer, shippers were really in control. They were able to get whatever rates they wanted. There was plenty of capacity. That's really changed in the last year or so. Capacity has really dwindled. Spot rates are through the roof. Carriers really are talking about rate hikes of 10% or even greater. So on one hand, you've got some new challenges driving the need for better and more efficient transportation management. On the other hand, you've got as much as two-thirds of the marketplace, two-thirds of the shippers out there that don't have a TMS. For a long time, the transportation software world was really limited to the top third of companies, the companies that spend $50 million a year or more on freight, that can in turn justify the expensive, long implementation project of a TMS. Mm-hmm. But what we're seeing right now is the market change. We're seeing that bottom two-thirds of company in terms of freight spend going out there and adopting TMS. There's a tremendous amount of activity, there's a tremendous amount of demand, and it's really changing how the market's actually looking.
I'm really quite shocked to hear that figure of two-thirds that have not embraced it. TMS has been around forever, it feels like. What has been the obstacle up to this point? Has it been a cost barrier? Has it been that they just didn't feel they needed that kind of a system? Or why up to this point?
You know, it's an interesting observation about TMS being around forever. It's a 30-year-old industry, much like warehouse management system, WMS. But if you look at the WMS space over 30 years, it's consolidated considerably. If you look at the TMS space, there's more and more innovation and new startups coming out every year. It's a very dynamic space. And what's really driven the adoption and these two-thirds companies that previously couldn't adopt it was cost, to your point. If you look at typical ROI of a TMS, it's 5 to 10% of your freight spend. Well, if I'm spending $50 million a year on freight spend, yeah, then I could maybe save $2.5 million to $5 million per year, and I could justify the 6-month, 8-month long project and the multiple hundreds of thousands of dollars to install. Mm-hmm. But the companies that spent maybe $10 or $15 million a year on freight spend, they really couldn't justify it. The ROI just wasn't there.
Help me to understand what a modern day TMS does.
Yeah, great question. So the modern day TMS helps me identify what is the best, most economical, and most service-centric way to get freight from point A to point B. It doesn't matter, frankly, if it's inbound coming in from my suppliers to my warehouse, outbound from my warehouse to my customers. At the end of the day, I've got product, I've got to move from A to B. Do I move it by itself? Do I move it truckload? Do I move it LTL? Do I consolidate with other loads? Once I build my plan, then I have to communicate with the carrier and identify, hey, I'm moving this shipment on this day from point A to point B. The carrier has to confirm it and then track it. You know, what's interesting is we've talked to all of our customers about why they originally chose our TMS and what benefits they plan on having versus what they're actually seeing. And of course, when everyone buys a TMS, they're thinking about that 5 to 10% freight savings. But the single common thread across all of our customers that we surveyed in terms of benefits they actually got was visibility. Nobody ever actually counted on getting visibility as part of their ROI because it's kind of a soft savings, right? You can't really put a number behind visibility, but every one of them to a T said, one of the most important benefits we've gotten from deploying the TMS is visibility. So to your question in terms of what does the TMS do, it picks the right carrier, it communicates with the carrier, and then it ultimately gives me that visibility to my freight in transit.
Do carriers prefer to work with shippers who have TMSs? You know, the big issue these days in this age of constrained capacity is this idea of becoming a shipper of choice. Is this someone that a carrier wants to serve? If you have a TMS, then you're communicating with that carrier. Does that make you a better customer?
It can. I would tell you it depends on A, the TMS. Is it modern and capable of communicating with me in a timely, effective, and efficient manner? And B, how do I use the TMS? Ultimately, you can have great technology, but if your team isn't using best practice and being shipper or carrier friendly, then it really doesn't matter.
Are there issues in integration? You had your WMS, you got your TMS, you got your order management system. Each system is individually trying to optimize its own criteria.
Right.
Is it possible that you could optimize one, sub-optimize another if they're not talking to each other and all working in concert?
You know, it's an interesting question, and it's been talked about as the holy grail for 20 years of convergence of supply chain and WMS and TMS working together. The reality is they work on different cycles, and so I'm either going to be a warehouse-centric operation or a transportation-centric operation. One is going to drive the other or vice versa. Working in concert, there's quite frankly a limited value there. When you talk about integration, frankly, the big benefit of transportation is not integration within my enterprise, but it's integration outside my enterprise. It's the reason why TMS is really the first supply chain system, or was the first supply chain system that was adopted by the cloud. Because the idea was, if I've got 50 or 100 or 400 carriers, being able to integrate with all those carriers just one time and handle all of that communication, that collaboration, just makes much more sense in the cloud.
Yeah. So we are in a growth cycle of this space, are we not?
Absolutely.
How long do we expect it to last?
So the latest stats I saw showed about 40 to 50% of companies are planning on buying TMS in the next, call, 2 years. Mm-hmm. So I think we've got at least 2 to 3 years left of the growth cycle because, again, it takes a long time for two-thirds of the marketplace to adopt a system. So I think it's between 2 to 4 years of this steady growth pace that we're seeing right now.
There are, of course, upfront cost considerations. Sure, you've got an ROI down the line, but does that mean that shipper size determines whether or not you're going to embrace a modern-day TMS?
Less so than it used to. The upfront cost is a lot smaller. In two senses. One, certainly cloud, I no longer have to deal with buying hardware or on-prem, so, you know, the on-prem license fee. But implementations are much faster now. The newer modern TMSs are installed in days and weeks instead of months and years. And so the actual services cost I have of paying a vendor or a consultant to implement a TMS, far, far less than it once was. And so, yes, of course, there's an upfront cost, but the ROI period is far faster than it used to be because those upfront costs are much smaller.
Mm-hmm. And upgrades and new versions because of the cloud technology, I imagine, are a lot easier to handle than they were before.
You know, it's a no-brainer. In fact, we've got a press release coming out tomorrow. We're doing an upgrade tomorrow, and it is a zero downtime upgrade. 5 or 6 times a year, our customers get an email, hey, here's the new features that are coming out. And you come in, and those new features are available. And that's not a plug for us. That's not unique to us. That's what the modern cloud software does.
So far, we've been talking only about technology, about bits and bytes, so to speak, but there are people involved still in this operation too, right? Tell me about the people aspect. What do they have to do on that side in order to make this work?
No, that's a great question. I'll tell you what's very interesting about TMS is if I don't have the right technology in place, 3/4 of my time is spent on phone calls and emails, despite having EDI and XML and web services and everything else that's out there in technology. So it is, by its very definition, transportation is a very collaborative, interpersonal environment. And that's where social networking technology can actually augment the people. You know, if you think about, essentially, I've got a social network where I've got my friends who are my connections, my carriers, my vendors, my distribution centers, and I've got messaging, instant messaging and photos and documents that should be going back and forth. And bringing that into the technology actually enables the people essentially to meld with that technology in a much more intuitive way, because that's what they do in their regular lives with Snapchat, Instagram, and Facebook.
What do you think a TMS of the future might look like? What do bells and whistles and aspects that it does not have today?
Whew, that is an interesting one. I will say that it looks a lot less like ERPs from 10 years ago, and it looks a lot more like something that Apple would design. It becomes simply intuitive. It's almost self-serve. If I want a TMS, it shouldn't take 6 months to select one and 4 months to implement one. It should be potentially go out to Amazon, find what I want, maybe follow a quick tutorial, and away I go. You know, the analogy I think about is my kid plays Xbox all the time. And Fortnite is the game everybody plays right now, all the NBA players, and he's on it 2-3 hours a day. He never had an instruction manual for Fortnite. He never followed a tutorial for Fortnite. He picked up the remote, downloaded the game, and started playing. And that is every bit as complex as a TMS or a WMS. So I've got to believe that as that generation is coming into the workforce and designing the software and demanding the software, it's going to look dramatically different. It's still going to tender, it's still going to rate, it's still going to optimize everything it does today, but how it does it and how we interact with the systems will be vastly different.
Yeah, very interesting. We'll be looking for that. But in the meantime, David, I want to thank you so much for bringing us up to date on the state of TMS today. Thanks very much for being with us.
Thank you, Bob.
I've been speaking with David Landau of Cloud Logistics. Thank you very much for watching.